Hey guys, this is Martin again from SIRS Electronics, and today I'm going to talk about the DMXIS. The DMXIS, it's a very cool little DMX interface, which allows performers and people that are on stage that don't really have a helping hand when it comes to lighting, cue their own shows and program their own settings so that they can run everything by themselves. You know, you don't have to have anybody there triggering all the shows and the sequences and the scenes and all that. And you know, today I'm going to show you how to set up a Footswitch pedal, how to set up presets, and how to just do basic chases and oscillations and stuff like that. You know, basically all you're going to need is a momentary Footswitch pedal, a laptop, and of course your DMXIS. So this is how it's done. I finally got everything set up here, all the equipment out and everything. And I'm going to show you real quick how to wire everything up. It's really simple and really to the point. So I previously daisy chained these two RGB LED fixtures, and I addressed one of them to address 1 and another one to address 4. They're all powered up. Everything's ready to go there. And they got my DMX line coming in here. So I'm going to set that aside for now. Okay. So basically here I have my software open. Then the next thing you're going to do is you're going to connect your DMXIS with the USB cable that it comes with. Connect that there. And since we're going to be doing the Footswitch operation here, we're going to connect it using a 1/4-inch mono jack. This is a regular instrument cable. And one of the ends goes to the switch. And the other end goes over here at the back of the DMXIS. So we connect that there. So now that this has been connected, and the next thing is the DMX cable. Now that it's all been connected, we're going to go here to the DMXIS software. And what we're going to first check is to make sure that we're actually getting DMX output signal. So we're going to click over here to go back, and then we're going to move one of the faders up and down, and you see there we do have the DMX signal coming out, which is a very good thing. Okay, so this is what the home screen for DMX looks like. We're going to go to the preset manager up here and click on that, and I already have some presets here set up, but we're going to create a new bank. Basically what a bank is a preset that holds presets. So we're going to go down here in the corner and click New. And it's going to ask us to label the bank. Let's just label it 3. Let's click OK. And then we select the bank. And once you select the bank, you'll see right here on the right, there is no presets. So you go down here to the bottom, click New. It's going to ask you to label the preset. Let's just label it 1. And we'll click OK. So we go here and we select the preset. And then we go back, hitting the preset manager, and you'll see all the faders there. For this test, I only have 6 available channels that I'm using. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Basically, it goes red, green, blue, red, green, blue. That's all I'm using right now. So the first thing we could create is a really easy preset. We could do a chase of red and red between each one of the fixtures here. So to do that, you click Control and you click the first fader, which is red for the first unit, for the first address, and then 4 while still holding Control. So that will select both of the faders. So now if you just click and drag, you'll see that they're both dragging together while you're just clicking 1. You see that they're highlighted. That means that they're together. Now you go down here on the oscillator, and you see here where it says type. If you click that once, now it's on sine. This is a type of chase pattern that it's going to do, which is the smoothest one. Now you see that they're not going all the way up. They're only going like halfway. There's another little knob here that says amounts. This will change how high the faders are going to travel from value to value. So now they're going from 0 to 255. And all they're doing is a flash. It's not really a chase. You go here where it says chase, okay? You select this, and that will actually now oscillate them. That will give it that chase movement. So depending on how you move it and how you play around with it, you'll get a different type of effects. Right now we're about 3/4 of the way in, and you can see it's more of a chase pattern. You also got the speed, which you could increase or decrease. If you move it to 16 bars, it's really slow. If you want to have like a more of a chase pattern, you could go through to 3/4 bar, or maybe your half bar, and that gives you a pretty fast chase. You could also change the shape, which is pretty much just the shape of how the wave is going to look, the chase is going to look. And then you got your master speed and your master level. Those you don't really, I mean, you can mess with them, but for now, we're going to leave them alone. So now that we have this going here, we're going to go back to the preset manager. You're going to make sure that your preset's highlighted. And you're going to go down here where it says overwrite, okay? That's going to save whatever changes you made on the faders, this little sequence here that we got going, to that preset. So you click overwrite. It's going to ask you, are you sure you want to do this? You say yes, and that's it. Now, we're going to create another preset, okay? So we go to new again, and let's label it as 2. Just keep things simple. And now we got another preset. So if you highlight that, it's still going to be running the previous show. So you'll see that the faders are still moving the way they were. So how do you stop this? Okay, to stop this, the easiest way to do it is to hold shift. You click the first one that's moving, and then to the last one that's moving. Now it's going to highlight the whole line. So you go down here to the oscillator, and you go where it says type, and you click this until it's off. Now they're off, you know, they're not moving anymore. So let's do like, let's say we want to do a white, just full on white preset. So we're going to select shift again, and we're going to click 1 all the way to 6, because those are all the 3 channels I'm using. So that's how you skip. Instead of pressing control, click, 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 here's just shift, click, click, and it just goes from one point to the other point, and it selects all the faders in between. So now you can move them all up together. Just put them on full blast. We go back to preset manager. Make sure it's highlighted, and you click overwrite, and click yes. And now you got 2 presets saved. So now we're going to click 1. That's our first preset, which is the oscillating red lights. And now we got our preset 2, which is our full white. Now, for the foot switch part, we're going to go here where it says show. Okay. Click show. And it says foot switch settings. And click on there. And you could use a 2-channel foot switch or a single channel. And you could create, you know, a bunch of stuff between those two. But for right now, we're using a single channel foot switch, and we're gonna go as for this foot switch type normally open. That means that when you're not pressing it, if the circuit is closed or open, that's gonna vary on the polarity on your selector on your foot switch. But we're gonna set it to where you're not doing anything, the circuit is open, so it doesn't trigger anything. So we're gonna set it there, normally open. Here I previously had set for the single click, you could put a load next preset. So when you tap it once, the switch, it'll load the next preset. Then we have double click setting. That is, if you click it twice, it'll jump to the previous preset. So that's what we have saved there. But if you see, you could select and set it up to whatever you want it to be. It's fully customizable. For right now, we're just going to do this. So single click, load next preset. Double click, go back to the previous preset. And click and hold, which means if you click it, when you hold it down, it's going to do a different effect. So for that, we have load next bank, which means it goes, you know, if you have a bank of, you know, different banks, and you want to go to the next one, you just click and hold it, and it'll move you to the next bank. And then if you click once, you'll go to the preset, okay? So now that we have that set, right here it says double click time. So depending, if you want it to be like a fairly quick change, if you double click pretty quickly, you could change the speed of your double click time and your click and hold time. So we have the click and hold time all the way up so that it knows you, when you're really holding on, that means next. So it doesn't just, if you tap it once, it thinks it's like the, you know, load of the next bank. So that's why I usually have that all the way up right there. And over here, I usually have this down so that the double click time is fairly fast so that it registers it fairly quickly. So we're going to save settings. Now that we have that set and we trigger 1, you'll see that it moved to preset 1. And if we trigger again, you see it goes to preset number 2. And that's being all done with a foot switch. You know, right now I'm pressing it with my hand. You know, it's meant to be pressed with your foot, but it's the same concept. So now let's say I want to go to a different bank. I already have some previous banks written in there. So I just click and hold. There we go. We're in bank 1. Okay. And to access the bank 1, you just click once, and it takes you to the first preset. That preset, I just have all the lights off. It's like my blackout. I click again. Goes to preset 1. Click again. And then it'll go to preset 2. Okay, so that's pretty much how this works. You just set everything there. And this is the beauty of this software, is that with this foot switch, it could be on the floor somewhere, whether playing guitar, singing, whatever it is that you're doing, DJing, whatever it is. With this, you could trigger everything without people really knowing you're triggering any of the stuff, because you could just have this down there somewhere and just click on it with your foot and you could trigger all these cool things. So it may take a little bit of training your brain to thinking, okay, which preset am I in? You know, how many clicks do I have to do? But once you figure that out, which all comes with practice, you could run this quite efficiently. So, you know, as you see, that's pretty much all there is to it. You know, you could do a mixture of selecting, you know, faders, changing the type of the chase, the amount, and, you know, you could create infinite amount of cool presets and setups. So that's pretty much all there is to it, guys. You know, so if you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, anything like that, go ahead and drop us a comment and let us know what you think. Thanks for watching. Thank you.